What up, though? Your boy Judy and this bitch. We was late. Technical difficulties. We get them like twice a week and shit. But I'll tell you what, I'll talk more. I'll give you more talk. Half the people are like, yes. And then the other half are like, shut the fuck up. And guess what I have to say to that? Fuck you, suck my dick, go listen to Hip Hop Nation. Or fucking, I'm really into fucking LL Cool J Station, that Rock the Bell shit. I'm not trying to throw shade. And I do RIP to Heavy D, but fucking A, that backspin. Every time I got in the fucking car, Heavy D was playing. Like he was Pac or some shit like that. It's like somebody's relative. Someone's related to Heavy D on that shit. It's the overweight lover in the house. I got a lot of information. Boom, boom, boom. Don't you know? Don't you know? And we had a last week we had a whole fucking we were talking about Don Lemon and Conor McGregor. Now Conor McGregor sucker punched some old dude because he wasn't stoked about his whiskey, and Don Lemon felt like he was being mocked by this man that was trying to buy him some lemon drops at a bar and allegedly stuck his finger down in his fucking crotch and then put it on his lip and rubbed it and was like, you like dick or pussy? You like dick or pussy? D or P? And the guy just stood there and took it. Now he's like suing him. And what we were saying is like, what would you be more likely to fight over? Having someone rub their dick hand on your lip or getting socked in the face? We asked you. We asked you and let's see. Did you already see the results? Chris, what do you think won?
I would think that Dick Fingers has to win.
You think Dick Fingers is the winner on that?
Somebody rubs Dick Fingers in my face, I'm not even thinking. Whereas if somebody punches me, I might maybe think for a second.
Yeah, because the other thing, sometimes a motherfucker might hit you so goddamn hard. I remember when I got beat up by the cops, there was one blow that just, it brought me back to like, they was fucking me up, and I was still standing, and I got there was just one blow that just knocked reality into me. I was like, oh, they're going to just keep beating you up if you're standing up, so you should lay your ass down. And then they beat me up some more. But shout out to the Pontiac Police Department. Yeah, fucking, that was a long time ago. No hard feelings. Can't get a gun now, but whatever. Who the fuck cares? They won't let me into fucking Canada or Australia. But yeah, sometimes you get hit so hard, that shit just be like, oh, okay, all right.
So it happened my senior year in football. Senior year of college.
Yeah.
I got hit once by a defensive tackle.
Yeah.
And I went down to one knee, and that was it. I didn't want to play anymore.
You were like, all right, I'm good. That motherfucker knocked the career out of your ass.
Wasn't like I was going anywhere anyway, but I was done.
Ain't that a bitch? That's fucking crazy as hell, but that shit, it does fucking happen. All right, let's see. I don't know what John answered. John, what did you? What do you think is going to be Dick? Did you see the results or no?
I just glanced down, but I didn't really see them. If I had to guess based on the way I know the people in the audience, I'm going to say people don't like the Dick Finger thing, which I wouldn't really have much of a problem with.
Surprising, surprising. You ain't got no lip, John, so that's why you're not worried about someone rubbing their dick finger on your lip. You're like, ah, try to find my lip. Good luck. Foiled again, fucker.
I mean, would you actually beat the person to the ground and just start stomping on them or just get them off you?
I don't know.
Oh.
I don't fucking know. You never know that shit. But if you do start stomping somebody, make sure you don't hit them in the head because that shit is fucking manslaughter. Which is fucked up. Especially, man, if you sleep somebody and then they, like, you really gotta, like, you really gotta be, it really has to be dire circumstances that you're in. If you, like, I've seen cats jumping on heads and shit, you're like, oh, man, like, stop that shit. And meanwhile, my man, is. It looked like he, it's crazy when they get knocked out with their hands up, because they'll be on the ground laying down, and it looks like they dancing to some song that just came on, like, oh, that's my shit. Their hands will be shaking. Nope, just knocked out sleep. I've been knocked out, and I'm going to tell you, fucking peaceful. As long as someone's not kicking you in the fucking head while it's happening, it is some peaceful ass shit. All right, here's the big reveal. On Facebook, 80% of the people said they would fight over dick fingers. And then on Instagram, it was damn near 75%. Or not Instagram, on Twitter. Oh, no, wait, that's Instagram. I didn't get the Twitter. Oh, wait, I didn't get the Facebook. Oh, no, no, I did. 108. I see. Now I see. Thanks, Kenan. All right, so the Twitter was fucking 80 to 20%. And then the Facebook was dick fingers wins by a mile. Nobody wants someone else to put their fucking manhood all in, on all about their face and mustache. Especially, like, man, anybody that's got a beard, you know that shit. Like, you eat some spicy soup or some shit, you can just smell it. It's just stuck. Or you eat some pussy, that shit gets stuck in your beard. You know, like, if Don Lemon did that shit, allegedly, it would just Don Lemon's dick out at the ocean all day. He had that fucking briny seafood dick all in his mustache.
But again, it is impossible for me to believe that Don Lemon actually did this.
You are a fucking
absurd.
You are a goddamn robot, John. Whatever they program you to believe, you believe.
He's been giving me information, useful
fucking
news
robot
for years.
Robot. Lots of people that do fucking cool shit also do weird shit. You know what that means? They're fucking human, John.
Yeah, but this is beyond weird. Walking up to a stranger and then shoving your dick fingers in their face. I mean, how often is that really happening out there?
I don't fucking know, bro. I don't be at gay bars. I don't know. I don't know how often it's happening, John. But just because it doesn't happen that often, we'll see. We'll see. It'll fucking unfold. It happened in a bar, so I'm sure there's fucking witnesses.
Innocent.
John, that's the problem with you, man. Like, you don't bend on nothing that is predictable. Like, if you're just like, maybe you could have done it, you know what I mean? Then you'd have more credibility.
Well, the only reason that I think that there's a chance, a very remote chance this could happen.
See, that's more like it. All right, keep going.
It's such a weird thing to come up with, unless it actually happened. It wouldn't even occur to me, hey, that guy put his hands in his crotch, down his pants, and then shoved him in my face. I mean, I've never even heard of that. So that's the only reason I think that there's a shred of a very small possibility that would have happened.
All right, there you go. We were talking about the Me Too shit, and that fucking lady allegedly said that Katy Perry tried to kiss her.
Right.
This is way worse.
It's pretty intense.
This is way worse. Yo, when I first got here to fucking Sirius, man, one of the big wigs got drunk and tried to fucking do some shit to me at the club.
What?
Yeah. And I was like, bro, get the fuck up off me. I ain't say shit because I didn't know, like, I just was like, yo, man, get up off me, man. I ain't gay, bro.
Is there any chance that you misread that?
No. Because he was like, let me ask you something. I was like, yeah, go ahead. And it's in the club, because, you know, you've been in the clubs before. Sometimes you got to fucking get in the motherfucker's ear to talk. Yep. And he was like, "Are you gay?" Well, I was like, "Nah, motherfucker." No, and then he tried to like turn in on me, and I fucking back and like fucking shoved him off me.
What happened to that guy?
He ain't here no more. Huh. But I ain't bring it up. Like it was weird. It was like, what am I gonna go? I felt like if I fought him, then I'm gonna get in trouble. And I wasn't into telling on people because I was new to this whole company policy shit. So I just kind of fucking just was like, damn, son.
Well, one of my superpowers is spotting gay people, and I've never once thought you were gay.
Thank you, man. I appreciate that, dog. Thank you. There's a few cats up in here I think are gay, or I think are at least fucking bisexual.
We'll talk later. I'll tell you for sure. Again, I'm like 100% on that.
You know what I'm thinking of?
Yes. No.
Yeah. I think that motherfucker.
Nope.
I think that dude is. There's a cat here. I think he's a six pack away from sucking dick.
No.
That's all I'm saying. That motherfucker is a six pack of beer claw away from sucking dick. I just learned what beer claw was last week. I'm gonna use it in a joke this week. Apparently, it's like Zima in a can. It's like bubbly seltzer.
You talking about White Claw?
Oh fuck me. Yeah, White Claw.
I was curious you mentioned that beverage, but he was talking about the beverage not that long ago.
The dude that I think is gay? Yeah, I told you.
He was.
I told you he's a six-pack of fucking White Claw away. I told
Uncle
you.
Bob.
That motherfucker.
I'm telling you, no way. Maybe down the road he'll...
Look, man, sometimes cats can't come to terms with that shit themselves. I've had homies or mutual friends where I'm like, yo, dude, you know that motherfucker just want to suck a fucking wheelbarrow of dicks. You know what I mean? You know that about them. But, like, they just can't come to terms with it because it's like maybe their family is against their religion or some shit like that. They don't want to feel ostracized, so they just push some fucking shits down. And then they get a couple drinks in them. Like, when I get faded, like, my fucking Michigan accent, like, I turn up. Like, I sound way more fucking... Like, right now, I'm like, this is my professional accent. Actually, hello. This is my professional accent. What seems to be the problem, officer? No, just me and the family. We're heading down over to the Home Depot. Gonna grab some plywood and build something.
It's convincing.
Thank you. Million times thank you. It's kind of hard to do this and think at the same time. But fuck me. Yeah, the fucking homies that get some fucking drinks in them and just turn sassy as hell. Like, whoa, where'd that fucking shit come from? Down, deep down, pushing all that gayness down, and then it comes out. I think one of the Jungle Brothers was like that.
Oh, that's right. I remember watching that video.
All right, yesterday, if you missed the show, you missed a lot. Camille. Is it Camille underscore Writes?
Yes.
Camille underscore Writes. At Camille underscore Writes. Go follow her. She wrote a really dope article on me for Penthouse. She's a listener to the show, and she was coming in town, and she wanted to sit in on the show. And somehow John got his hooks in her.
My hooks. That is a very strange report.
John got a hold of her ass and set up like a date.
I don't see that's
you took her on a walk in the wilderness, right? And then you took her to dinner.
I did.
She doesn't sound like a date to me.
She had the salad. I had the sausage sandwich.
Oh my god,
it's
dude.
A good sandwich, man.
Man, you just don't even think about, like, you just don't care, do you? Breathing fucking sausage breath all over him, just garlic and smelling bologna and shit.
That had occurred to me.
Yeah, but you just still went with that. I couldn't stop yourself.
I know what I like.
I'm gonna get a sausage sandwich, a side of onion rings.
By the way, as I was ordering it, I almost flinched.
You got any blue cheese dressing back there, too? I want my mouth to smell like a fucking butthole, an armpit, and a dick at the same time.
Go outside, have a cigarette, come back in.
So anyway, while John is taking this walk with Camille, he fucking, Camille brings up the fact, while they're walking in the woods, Camille brings up the fact that she likes to fuck in the wilderness and be one with nature. And you know what John did? John didn't fuck her.
Kept it mellow.
And put her in an Uber, then went and got drunk by himself. And then lost his cell phone.
Left it in the
Uber. Is that an accurate?
Well, those are facts, but it's the way you tell the story, it sounds horrendous. Now, I don't know of a good way of telling this story, to be honest.
Well, because there's only one way to fucking tell the goddamn story, bro. You literally, like, I don't know. If I'm in a fucking certain spot, like, let's say I'm in Disney World with a chick, and she's like, I'd always wanted to get fucked in the Disney World bathroom. I would be like, she probably wants us to have sex in the Disney World bathroom. Let's go find a fucking family bathroom and smash.
Again, critical to the story is like, I just met this lady.
It doesn't fucking matter. Why are you acting like fucking time? Time is all relative, bro. Time is an illusion.
It's not as though she was...
Time is an illusion. It's all compacted. Don't you like science and shit?
Yeah. But you make it sound as though she was sort of taking off her shirt while she was saying that she wanted to go fuck in that hole over there or something. That's not... It wasn't that hot and heavy. Maybe I just misread it.
So we're going to do Hate or Love It, and then we're going to find out. Then, so she comes in. She comes in yesterday, sitting in here with the fucking white negligee onesie thing, just seeing the nipples and all that shit.
I was surprised by that. I really was.
And, yo, she was throwing me a little vibe, and she was fucking throwing you a vibe, and I'm like, you know what? I'm going to lay off. I gave Chris $60 not to take John to go get his fucking phone.
Which just sucks.
Fuck you. You should have. Fuck your phone. Fuck you. And a lot of people, I'm going to get ahead of this one. A lot of people just go on fucking Uber, look at your receipt, lost items down at the bottom, clicking that you lost the fucking item. And they'll bring it to you, man.
Well, I've been going back and forth with Uber for fucking 24 hours now.
All right, man. It's $200, bro. Just get a new fucking phone. No one calls you anyway, John.
I think we're getting there.
No one calls you anyway.
Not with good news, that's for sure. Those fucking emergencies, problems.
All right, so we're going to find out. Fine. We're going to find... It's basically going to be two... We got Hate or Love It coming up next. And it very well could be two Hate or Love It's. If you didn't fuck. And we're going to find out. We're going to find out. In approximately 45 minutes, if John smashed or not. It was there. She even said she wanted it. Did she not say she was down when she got here?
She was very explicit when she was here.
Yeah, she was down.
I did not see that coming. That's for sure.
And we're going to get her on the phone, too. Just to get both sides of the story, because I'm sure your side is going to be the fuck side. Oh, bullshit ass side.
My side is always true.
My side is always true. And Mr. True. They call me Chinny McTrue a lot.
Nothing but the facts.
Fucking lie. You a goddamn lie. Alright. Play some music and we'll be back. Shade 45th. It's an all out show, your boy Judy.
You're listening to the all out show with you.
In what might possibly be the most controversial feature on the radio today.
Bitch, don't play that shit on this radio no more.
This is the place where careers are made.
That shit was awesome, I love it.
And broken.
Yeah, what's up, you fucking poser, man? That shit was whack.
It's time for Hate It or Love It on Shade 45.
Yo, what up, though? We got Grind Lab in here. Where you from, Grind Lab?
Yes, sir. Grind Lab from Dallas, Texas.
Okay. Repping Texas? Who else? Yeah. You and the DOC. Feel the Fresh Crew, I believe. There was another Texas group that was big too. All right, what do you do with what do you do for a living?
Man, I'm an artist full time, either making beats, do graphic design, doing a little bit of music, getting paid off that, and just full time hustling, anything creative.
Awesome. All right, cool. Tell me about the song that you're gonna play.
All right, this song Shattered. I zoned in to like create this album. Pretty much stayed like in my home, turned it into a studio, had multiple artists. I was going through this relationship right off the bat. That shit was toxic, and it was just me and this girl in the house, and I just pretty much fucking freestyled that shit right in front of her. She was in the kitchen, you know, just telling her how much, like, how fucking dirty this relationship's going already. I don't got a fucking heart. You can't break me. This shit shattered, and that's just what came out.
So you are, let me just get this straight. You're at the house and you guys are going through a tough time, and she was in the kitchen. What was she doing? Cooking or just chilling? Or
probably looking for a fucking beer.
All right, so she's in the kitchen, and then you just start freestyling at her.
Yep, I had the beat going. I just started looping it, started freestyling it, started making tapes, started finding that voice, and just playing with dynamics. Because, like I said, I was just tuned in working.
That must have worked really well. That must have worked really well, arguing with her, like, in a freestyle.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, if a girl started freestyle rapping at me, I'd be like, get the fuck out of here. What the fuck is this? 8 Mile? I'd hit her with a shoe. Get out of here. Shoe.
Yeah.
Throw a cup of water on her. All right, so this song is that. This is probably the most unique birthplace of a song we've had so far. Was you arguing with your girl in the kitchen and just freestyled this, and then out came Shattered.
Yes, sir. Pretty much.
That's fucking crazy, man. All right.
Appreciate that.
Yeah, Grime Lab out of Dallas, Texas. He's a graphic artist and as well as a rapper, and you make beats. Did you make this beat?
No, I co-produced it. I'm not even going to mention the guy who made the beat, because that guy ended up fucking that girl later, like in that house too. So adding to the story.
What? Hold up. So you made this? You made this beat with your homie,
and then
he fucked your. He fucked her.
Yeah, like a whole toxic shit. I was passed out. He fucked her, and then that shit just hit the fan, and completely everybody got kicked out the house. I closed down that house, all that shit. So Shattered was recorded probably like days before that happened.
Damn, man. And was he in the room when you was doing it?
Nah, he was just in the house. I passed out.
No. When you were making the fucking song, was he like, all right, punch up this bar a little bit more. Just like
Hell no, he wasn't there at all. I just did it completely myself. All
right, that's what I wanted to know, because that would have been fucking crazy. Like, he's telling you what to do. Yeah. Meanwhile, he's fucking your girl and shit. Do you think that was the first time you hit?
Yeah, it was the first and only, she told me, and it was a mistake or whatever. I was like, fuck that,
She felt guilty about it and told you.
Yeah, and I could care less, because I wasn't in my heart or nothing. I was just like, the trust is shattered, you know, all that shit shattered. I don't trust y'all, none of that stuff.
When she told you that, did you rap at her again?
Nah, bro. Actually, bro, I flipped out on it, but she told me right in front of everybody, and I just, like, smiled all that shit and just, like, you know, started cutting after everybody. I didn't even, like, get into it. I didn't snap at her, nothing. I just went cold, you know. I just, like, you know what, fuck you. I'm not, like, giving you no more attention. None of me. Just work on me. And, of course, you're going to be emotional and fucking sad and all that, but I said, fuck that. You didn't get faded.
Nah, she ain't feel that bad if she told you that she fucked your boy in front of everybody. That's a one-on-one conversation.
No, it was one-on-one, but other people were, you know, in the house.
Okay.
Yeah, like the other people were in the house.
However
yeah.
you want to see it. You ready?
I didn't murder nobody that day, shit.
That's congratulations. I know, right? I'm glad. Yeah, I'm glad. I'm glad no one died.
Yeah, man.
All right, so the song is Shattered. People already call it. You got fucking X out the lines. The song is Shattered. Call up 888-742-3345 and let us know whether you hate it or love it. We got Grime Lab out of Dallas, Texas. Let's go.
And I'm the only one in life. And I'm the only one in life. And I'm the only one in life.
You get support me. Shattered in my pillow, smoking drink. Nothing matters. Your love is an addiction. All of it is so strong. I mean it right. I'm the only one in love. You disagree? Oh, we make me shatter. In my pillow, smoking drink. Nothing matters. Your love is an addiction. All of it is so strong. I'm the only one in love.
And I'm the only one in life. And I'm the only one in life. And I'm the only one in life.
You can't break my heart, I don't have one. You can't be the only one I've had more. Everything that I have inside, all of my emotions pushed to the side. Evil bitch, run my mind. Shape and point, make me high and dry. Yeah, you know why.
I got a new one, she not a new one. She been here since the jump.
She gotta go up, drink and throw up. Do it all over again, she my princess, huh?
You disappoint me, always feeling shattered. But the love I gave you, it never really mattered.
You disappoint, always leave me shattered.
That song was called Shattered by Grime Lab out of Dallas, Texas. In case you're in case you just tuned in and didn't hear the story behind it, it was like this all came from a bad relationship he had with his girl. All right, you ready, Grime Lab?
Yep, ready, man. Appreciate the play, appreciate the blessing to be on here right now.
Let's go to the phone lines. 888-742-3345. Trina.
Man, I hated that shit. The fuck you doing? You from Texas? You supposed to rip. I'd have called Paul Wall, Willie D, all of them to come beat your ass. That's, you ought to be ashamed of putting that bullshit on the radio.
Damn. No.
He ain't got no comeback. That's what I'm saying. That's some sorry ass shit.
We lost him.
I'd have fucked somebody else too. God damn. That shit, and you freestyle that shit to that bitch. I'd have fucked your daddy, your uncle, all of them. God damn, you need to go and start over with that boo. I'm telling you, and then Texas, don't tell nobody else you're from Texas.
Y'all don't want him. y'all don't want him. All right,
we
bye.
Got him back.
All right, we lost him.
Got him back.
888-742-3345. 888-742-3345. Let me know when you get this cat back. Is he you there?
Yeah,
Grime Lab? All right, so you got one hate. Don't let that get you down. Let's go to Greg in New Hampshire. Greg, go ahead.
Yo, what up? What's going on, Jude? Hey, dude. You should find a way to graphic design out of that, because that was just absolutely terrible, bro. There's no wonder why your girl left you, you know, like, for the guy that apparently made that beat.
Honestly,
you wanted to put someone with some real talent, bro, because you sound like a Mongolian throat singer right there. You know, I don't know what the fuck you're
trying
to
do. Mongolian, that's psycho.
You say you're from down in Texas, bro. You're trying to sound like you're out in, like, the middle of, like, the Caribbean, dude. I don't
you
know
what
you're trying
you know
to
about
do.
Real music,
get
honest,
back to whatever
you're trying to like you.
Back to school.
Where's your song on the radio, bro? Where's your music on? Where's your shit at then?
That, bro. For real. Like, okay. I don't even know why you would even want to send that in. You just embarrass yourself. You embarrass your old girl. You embarrass the dude that she banged, bro. Like, I don't even know where to begin with you.
Okay, so that's...
You hate it? You hate it? You know who the fuck I am? Grandma, bro.
So he didn't like it. He didn't like it. Let's go to Los Angeles. Lamar in L.A.
What up, L.A.?
What's up, Jude?
What up, though?
Hey, dude, I got one question for you, homie.
Go ahead.
Do you listen to this raggedy ass shit before you put it on the radio?
No, John always play. John, it goes to John first. John, I know. I hear it when you guys hear it.
John. I'm blaming John for putting this raggedy ass trash music on the radio.
Nah,
that shit was so fucking whack, nigga. Bro, that's why your bitch left you, dude. Cause you're fucking, you're trash, dude. You're lame, nigga. You're not a rapper. You're not a fucking rapper, bro.
I'm a musician. I get paid off this shit, and I'm glad I'm here, bro. I'm glad I'm fucking fucked, bro.
Go get a job. Go get a fucking job.
He's
go
like,
get you a fucking girlfriend. Get you a Christian Mingle app and find you a good bitch, bro. Because you're not going to be a rapper, my nigga. It's never going to happen for you.
He's just emotional. He like, you like the Drake of Texas. You know what I mean? Just,
I'm emo, dude. Fuck yeah.
You just emo. Let's go to Alex in North Carolina. Alex.
Hey, what's up? Hey, dude, you know what I like about this song? Is it really makes me appreciate actual fucking hip hop music, because that was fucking so terrible, dude. If Dill Pickle Juice had a sound, that's what it would be. That's what the sound of Dill Pickle Juice
word,
is so
word, but you
terrible
know,
on all streams of everything. That's what it sounded like. Dill fucking Pickle Juice, dude.
I actually like Dill Pickle Juice.
Dude, go down to like somewhere and buy something, and then just throw it away, and you'll know what we all feel like, dude.
You funny as shit, bro. That's making my day. Hey, what up, dude? I'm glad. I'm glad you sound like a female or some shit. I don't know what's up. All hopefully right. You are. Just look at that.
That was Alex from Texas, or from North Carolina. Yeah. Hey, let's see if Chicago's doing okay. Jose and Shy.
What up, Shy?
Hey, what's up, Pilsen? Buddy?
Go ahead.
Hey, that shit was tight, actually. I got to give it some love.
Okay.
Man, I appreciate that. Yeah.
Hey, but while we on it real quick, hey, did John get pussy last night?
We're going to let y'all know after this. Don't go anywhere. All right, so you got one love. Three hates, one love.
Right.
You're still in the game.
Right.
You're still in the game. 888-742-3345. Matt in Toronto, home of Drake, by the way. And I said you're the Drake of Texas. Go ahead, yeah. Matt.
Hey, what's up, man? Yo, you know what I liked about that song? When it fucking ended, that shit was trash, man.
Yeah.
I was crying on the beat, yo. Grow a fucking set of balls, bro.
Man, I'm going to stay me. I'm going to stay doing whatever the fuck I want. Emo rapper, grime rapper. I rap with my emotions. I don't rap no fake shit. I just rap about how I rap.
You know what you should do? Go back to school, get a fucking trade, and put the mic down, man. That shit was trash, bro.
Bro,
I don't even like Drake. I'm from Toronto. I don't even like Drake, and I say Drake is better than that shit.
Yeah, you're going to remember Grime Lab doing it. You see me again.
Let's go to the South Bay.
Let's go.
All right, Damien in the South Bay. Go ahead. Hate or love it, Damien.
That shit was fucking horrible.
Oh, wow.
It's fucking, it sounded like a fucking, yeah. Just fucking ridiculous nursery rhyme shit. No wonder you're fucking homeboy. Fuck your fucking lady. Nobody's going to want to fucking listen to that shit, dude. It's fucking horrible.
Y'all just
it sounds like
shit,
whether it's
horrible
or not,
your
bro.
Fuck it. It's out there.
Like
it's out there.
In your
Were you surprised? Are you surprised at the
like the hate on it?
Yeah, the feedback you're getting. Right now it's like 4-1 hate to love.
Yeah, that you know what? This music that sounds completely different. I don't think I'm sounding like no one.
Right.
It ain't no norm or nothing, so it's just breaking in my own category, my own term.
I'm a bit surprised,
bro,
too.
I don't care about hate or love.
All right, well, let's just keep it going. Just keep going. Free out of Phoenix. Hate or love it. Free.
Yo, I'm a veteran. I just smoked my blunt today. I was doing good. I took my doggy to the groomers, and I hear this shit, son. I hear this shit. I took my kid. I just took this dog to the groomers,
boy.
And I'm out here mad. Like, why does this sound like Tales of the Crypt music? What the fuck is going on with him? How did he ever get a girl? When you rap, you should just close your eyes and dream about rapping. You shouldn't even do that shit in reality. You shouldn't even breathe. For real, and do that. You should only breathe to sleep. You should not
no
do
way.
Nothing
okay.
else, yo.
I believe.
Why did it sound like 18 diggers at once in the beginning of the song when you came on saying your goofy ass name? Why did it sound like it was like a whole collage of like some some failed fucking church singers, dude. Like, what the fuck are you talking about?
Put your shit out there.
I'm gonna start rapping because of whoever you are. I'm going free from Phoenix. It's about to start throwing and murdering your niggas.
So right, free. Start, free.
You make your money off of that shit, son. You make your nickels. You make
your free. All right, free. You were in the armed forces. What was easier, being in the armed forces or listening to this track?
Ooh, this hard. Boot camp with no pussy for fucking 9 weeks was easier than listening to that shit. Even having a conversation with him right now was easier than that.
Okay, all right, say no more. Let's go to California, Ken. California, Ken. Go ahead, hate or love you. Yeah.
Oh, man, I hate that fucking shit. I hate this guy with a passion. Someone needs to dig this motherfucker in the grave and kill his ass.
Wow.
I can't believe you let this motherfucker on your show.
Like, I can't, really can't.
Man.
Come on.
I can't believe it, bro.
You know what's better than that.
Huh? No. That's garbage, bro. That's garbage. Yeah. Man, I tell you what. Let's get the dump truck and back up over that shit, because that's garbage. You should never, ever, ever think about rapping again.
Damn.
You should go get you a regular job.
Keep rapping, keep putting shit up. I'm glad y'all hate it. I'm glad y'all heard it, man. Grind out there. Fuck it. I appreciate the hate, bro. I appreciate whatever love. It's a fucking blessing to be here. Grind, I'm going to keep putting shit out. People are going to keep listening. I'm going to keep doing me, because I ain't trying to do nothing else.
Maybe it's so just because these cats are from, like, the coast and shit. Let's go down south and see how you get some love from E-Money. And Hattiesburg, Mississippi, got some love for Grime Lab?
No love here, man. That shit is like eating unclean chitlins, man. That's some bullshit, man. Hey, dude, that shit was fucked up, man. Whoever told you you can rap, man, they fucking lied to you, man. You need to go kill yourself, cuz.
Wow.
If y'all listen to him talk about how he sound like he's crying, man. Hey, listen. We from down south, man. You're embarrassing us down south, man. Hey, don't quit your day job, man. Hey, Lil Caesar is hiring, cuz. You need to go get a job, baby.
All right, so...
Hey, for sure, yeah. But after I'm fucking finishing dying off this music, because this is all I fucking do, I don't eat off rap, but I eat off making beats, production mixes, so this is my life. I'm going to keep doing me, bro. Keep doing me. Respect you.
Let's go to Carlos in Alabama. Carlos.
Hey, I just want to say, Jude, I appreciate for the first time you let an artistic dude rap on the show. That is awesome, man. You know, you're giving the underdeveloped a platform, because I hate this song. I'm a veteran, and I almost wanted to go back to Iraq and say, listen to this goddamn dude rap. You need to stay single, goddammit. I don't want you to ever get a girlfriend again, because if you do, we're going to hear this shit again. So you stay single, or go get a harmonica and stay on the porch. But you just made me love my woman even more, because I can't ever goddamn listen to shit like this again. I tried to chew off my goddamn ear instead of hearing this goddamn mumble-bumble shit here. But again, Jude, thanks for helping out the autistic, man. You are awesome cat.
All right, man. We're not...
autistic community on the hill,
baby. Yo, shout out to everybody on the spectrum. Okay, I don't think anybody else really gets to talk after that.
He killed it. That shit, either way, bro, the hate, shit's real, bro. Shit's real. You gotta be hated to be loved, bro.
Yeah, I'm sorry that you didn't. If it makes you feel better, let's see. I'm looking at the call. There's still a bunch of calls. Let me go down the line.
It don't matter. Whatever you feel, bro.
It's all hates, bro. It's all hates. It's all. Now, I was looking for like one love for you to end on a good note, but fuck it.
Fuck it, bro. It's one of them days, but appreciate it.
You didn't win Grime Lab. I'm sorry. The upside is that you're not involved with that chick that fucked your homeboy, and you're not friends with that guy anymore. You get that,
man, fuck that.
Toxic shit
is,
out of
I
your
got
life.
On State 45, yeah. Whatever, dude. Hope you have a blessed one. That's the upside. Every day is a blessing.
There you go. Every day is a blessing. Thank you, Grime Lab. He lost on Hater to Love It, but... Yeah, no, he just lost on Hair Love It, man. There was really no upside to that. His girl got fucked and shit. That's a bummer, too. And the guy he made beats with doesn't do that with him anymore. So it's just... That's all-around bad look. Okay. All right. Well, let's play some music and come back.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
All right, Shea 45, we are back. In case you missed the show yesterday, you missed a pretty fucking good show. I ain't gonna lie. Did you hear that? All right, it went away. All right, I had a little echo. I'm not going to lie. And it came out of nowhere. So this is what happened. There's a woman who is an ex-stripper, writes erotic fiction and nonfiction, and writes for Pet House, who also listens to the All Out Show. And she interviewed me for the Pet House magazine. You can look it up online. I think it's on @onemorejude.com if you want to see the interview. And she smashed the fucking interview. So she hits me up. She's like, hey, I'm going to be in town. I'd love to come by the show. We kick it over to Keenan and John. And somehow, John gets a fucking date with this woman. Or gets to hang out with her. Stop me if I fuck anything up, John.
Yeah, that's it.
So.
Straight so far.
John takes her hiking, as he does with every fucking girl. I don't know why he fucking... It's probably because it's cheap. It's free. Take her up in the hills and shit. They see nature. I'm like, not my idea of fun, but whatever. Fucking have to climb a hill to get some pussy. Fuck that shit. Anyway, but while John and Camille are walking, Camille's talking about like how it's hot to fuck in nature. And how it, like, it's good to be one with nature and get like go on the roughage and just get it in. John, did you fuck her in the nature the other a few days ago?
I did not have sex in the woods.
No, he did not have sex with her in the woods. He put her in a fucking Uber, then he went and got drunk by himself and lost his phone.
At that point, I'd known her for probably, well, I've been with her for probably like a couple hours.
Doesn't matter. She knows you. She listens to the show, bro. You keep forgetting that. She's intimate with you. She knows all about you. She knows about your doo-doo cum water, drinking the fucking doo-doo cum water underwear. She knows everything about you. And she's still walking in the woods with you talking about fucking.
She accepts a lot.
Yeah. And she wrote an article on me like, this was like a chick that was hanging out with me that I didn't sleep with that you could have fucking slept with and been like, yeah, oh, that chick, Camille, nice girl. She wrote an article on you. Really sweet. Yeah, we're kind of a thing sometimes when she comes into town. Could have said that.
Could have said a lot of things.
And all you gave a fuck about yesterday was your fucking phone.
Well, that's still an ongoing problem.
Did you get your phone?
I have not received it. No.
You didn't get your phone.
It died at this point, and now I'm going back and forth with Uber.
Why don't you just fucking buy a new phone? You got $200. Is Camille there?
Camille is, in fact, there.
Camille, did you hang out with John at all after the show, or?
I did.
Okay.
We went to this really cute Chinese place. John, trying to think of the name.
Is it Ching Chong Chinese? Or
you're getting warmer. That's very close.
Starts with an F.
Fucking awesome Chinese.
Fuchu.
Yeah, some
I
shit.
Don't know. Whatever.
All right, yeah. So, and everybody, like, I even felt like, maybe I was wrong. I felt like you was even throwing me a little vibe, but I was like, nah, you and John had some shit, so I just kind of like backed off. That could have just been my own hubris, you know what I mean? So I just like backed back because I didn't want to cock block John. Even though he deserved it.
Well, Camille, could he have blocked my cock? Is that what we're talking about here?
I mean... Yeah, I mean, first
fine.
Time that I met Jude, but it was just me and Jude alone in his house. I mean, anything could have happened. I mean, Jude's got plenty of freaking good music. Hello.
Okay. Yeah. The last time I fucking did that with a chick, like she wouldn't publish anything until I kept fucking her again. So I was like, I'm not going down that fucking road again. We're going to keep this strictly professional.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Not that I don't find you attractor, because I do find you attractor.
I know. Thank you.
All right. So, John, did you seal the deal yesterday? Did y'all have coitus? Did you fuck?
There was no intercourse. There was no fucking. There was no kissing. There was no heavy petting. There was no fingering.
What?
There was no cunnilingus.
the fuck, dude?
Nope. There was no, not even.
What the fuck?
You know, I mean, I think there is somebody. I can't say I didn't deserve that. Alex, you want to help me?
No, before I finish telling the story. What? So you didn't sleep with her? You didn't finger her? You didn't kiss her?
Nope.
You didn't do shit?
No. But I think, you know, see, the way it went down, see, we were at, of course, the restaurant, and that was a normal meal.
I'm listening. Just
keep
going.
That was the normal meal, and then we went to the bar to have a cocktail afterwards. Very friendly. She was, you know, very warm, and she touched me. You know, even her leg came and touched my leg.
Oh my God!
I figured that was a good sign.
How did you guys not like what?
And she was still wearing that sort of hot romper thing.
Oh my God! Yeah, she was wearing like this little shorts romper thing. Or you can look at All Out Show,
yeah.
Or go to @Camille_rights to see her.
And
888-742-3345. This is gonna be like another hate it or love it. You know that, John.
By the way, all the guys when
888-742-3345.
All the guys when we walk in, they all shoot over at us because she's sort of rocking that romper.
So you had all the guys wanted the girl that
right.
You came in there with.
Correct. I could have taken a poll.
Why did what? Were you close to your place?
No. We were nearby here. We were not far from here. So
you're in K-Town, right?
Yeah.
That's not that far, bro.
It's not far. No. So, I mean...
You went to Formosa Cafe?
Yeah, how the hell do you know that?
Because that's the Chinese restaurant where Frank Sinatra used to hang out right down the street.
Oh, okay. Yeah, so... Yeah.
Oh, my God.
All right, but, you know, all right, so...
I mean
you went
I mean,
to where Frank Sinatra
totally.
Went and couldn't even fucking... Old Blue Eyes, the pussy killer?
Yeah, it's...
Camille, what happened?
His ghost didn't set me up.
Yeah, so I... John definitely gets points for taste because I really like that place. I mean, it was just, I mean, dim lights, I mean, mood lighting.
It's a
I mean,
sexy
John,
little spot. It's a sexy little feel.
Dude.
If you feel like you're like in back in the 1950s.
Absolutely. I mean, John definitely could have made a move. And John had more wine than I did.
I
so
had two glasses.
He was nervous.
Shocked.
He was nervous.
A little bit.
I was shocked that John didn't make a move, actually, you know?
Oh, my God.
Bullshit. I'm calling bullshit on that.
Did you ask, did you say you want to go back to my place?
Yes, I did, in a way that was a little, it needs a little work.
What did you say?
All right, so we were leading up to it, and then at the end, so we even went for coffee afterwards.
Did you go for coffee did you be like, hey, let's hop on Uber, I know a coffee spot by me.
Yeah, that would have been better.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, my
but again,
fucking God.
There's a bit of a problem with the whole phone thing. She's rocking the Uber last night, so that was the problem. I couldn't make those kind of moves.
You could have just gave her some money.
Yeah, I already got her Venmo. We're good. But now,
yeah, right. You could have just Venmo'd her the money.
All right. So, but we're at the coffee place having the coffee.
Oh, my God.
And it's getting late. And then at some point, what I said, and this is exactly what I said, what was it? I would be remiss if I didn't invite you back to my place.
And that is exactly what he said.
Yeah. Which I think was a mistake.
Sexy.
No.
Sexy
not
talk.
Sexy. And
sexy boy. I would be remiss. I don't even know. Let me fucking go look that shit up on fucking.
I don't know why I said
on
that.
Webster Dictionary.
Honestly, the moment I said it, I regretted it. And so then she said, it's getting kind of late. I want to go lie down. I said, okay. And then at some point, she said, well.
She just had coffee.
I know. I was trying to stimulate her. And then
she just had coffee and told you that she was getting late.
I know that. I know that. But and then at some point I made the mistake because she said, I wonder how much the Uber will cost. And at that point I sort of had this mistake to think that she was coming back to my place. So I said, oh, about $12, and then, you know, I see that she's actually typing in where she's staying. I was like, oh, I see. Okay. Never mind.
Why did you change your mind? Because you was down the day before. Why did you change your mind, Camille?
Oh, me? Let's just say that when we went over to John's neighborhood, I wasn't sure if I should be over there.
When did you go? Did you go to John's neighborhood or no?
Yeah. So
the Uber dropped John off first, and then he dropped me off. So I had a tour of John's hood last night.
By the way, I do not believe this is real. I'm calling bullshit in this. Are you fucking serious?
That's the only. Come on, I don't believe that either. I don't buy that shit either. Like, you're literally hopping out of the fucking Uber into his place. It's not like there was where they shoot. Were they throwing hand grenades?
No.
Why did you that like?
Because in all seriousness, she didn't know how kind of sketchified it is. But it's a fine place. But she didn't know that until we got there. So are you saying in the Uber, you were still weighing the options of, hey, I'm going to go have some of that John dick? Is that what we're talking about?
Yeah, I mean.
By the way, that also occurred to me. Are you being fucking serious? You didn't like the neighborhood? Are you kidding me?
What streets are you by?
Like Wilshire and Venice, that area. It's like Wilshire and Venice.
Wilshire and Venice run parallel.
No, sorry. Western and Venice.
All right, it's a little, but it's not that bad. I was slaying chicks in
Korea. John definitely got points for his taste, though. I mean, I love that Chinese restaurant.
It's the fucking apartment? Are you kidding me?
I want y'all to scroll through these callers and get just. I just want the strongest callers. I don't want one fucking dud.
So
I don't want one fucking dud. Drop the weak ones. I'm telling you that right now.
John was a complete gentleman, though.
And so when you said
definitely
I could
give him that.
When you said I could have made a move, what does that mean? What does that look like in your world? I mean, suddenly.
Did
so,
you kiss on her or like grab her ass or anything?
At some point, she's cold, but she's half naked out there in the street.
Yeah.
And then she said, "Well, give me a hug." And then we're sitting there in this like prolonged hug.
Oh,
and
yeah.
I thought, okay, yes. That would have been the time. That would have been the time.
Yeah.
Seriously? So, I mean, that would have been...
What the fuck?
Right.
She was like, I'm cold, give me a hug, and then you just, like, you ain't do shit else to her? You just sat there and fucking, like, rested your fucking... I can just see John hugging her ass and, like, his big-ass chin hanging over her fucking shoulder.
It was
not
right there,
doing anything.
Right there on the corner.
Oh, my fucking God,
she
John.
She's goosebumps going, so I gave her back a little rub, trying to get those down. Yeah, this was not my finest errand.
John definitely helped me to keep warm, though. Definitely.
I am just horrified that it's...
Good taste in keeping her warm.
I'm stunned by this neighborhood thing. I mean, I got to ask one more time. Are you being serious about that? Is that real?
If you had an ounce of game, she would have looked past your neighborhood. I don't believe that shit one sec.
I don't either.
This dude's in the hood getting tons of fucking pussy.
Yeah.
In way worse neighborhoods than that.
It's nothing. I mean, you know, strangers come into the apartment once in a while, but that's about it.
Oh, yeah, you had a fucking homeless lady run up.
Yeah, I did last night.
Oh, my God. Yeah. Jesus Christ.
She was wasted.
All right.
No, I mean, John and I definitely had a good time, though, and John had great taste. I mean, I love that place where we went. John was downing the wine.
I had
definitely had way more wine than I did. Probably
was he a bit drunk?
You know, I'm not sure.
Was he a bit drunk sounding?
John was, you know, a little toasty. Yeah.
I had two glasses of wine.
You're an alcoholic.
It would take a bottle and a half for me to start showing.
All right.
I mean, what are you talking about?
Camille, I'm gonna. If you want to stay on hold and listen to everybody talk to John, I'm gonna put you on hold and we'll take some calls.
Okay.
I had two glasses of wine.
888-742-3345. You had one fucking job, dude.
I had two glasses of wine.
You had one fucking job. I left. She was down to... She was DTF. She was down to fuck, son. She was down to fuck.
I know.
And she came up here wearing fucking nothing.
I know, man. No.
Wearing nothing.
Hey, I mean, I even thought that, of course, we were heading in that direction. But
you literally took her to a place the opposite direction than your fucking house. This is when you'd be like, hey, let's go back to my crib. We'll order some fucking Grubhub and just chill. I got all that fucking wine sitting in there. Shout out to Orange Swift. I got all that fucking wine just sitting in there. You think I'd have fucking held that against you if you would have grabbed a bottle of wine to go chill with a fucking girl?
But really, I did have to clean up my place a little bit, so
you
dodged a
fucking
bullet there.
Bitch.
I was a little surprised that it didn't come together.
Oh.
I was. But, I mean, I think a different person could have turned that around if they were sort of used to that. But I'm not the kind of guy, if I just don't think it's happening, I'm like, okay, that's fine. But I mean, I think somebody else would have pressed. I think they would have turned that screw a little bit harder.
It was there, bro.
I know that.
It was there. You ruining shit for men.
I think
for men all around. Lamont.
Damn it.
Hey, what's going on, Jude? Hey, John, you are a bitch-ass motherfucker. Dude threw you an assist to get some pussy, and you ain't even try to get none?
He really did.
What the fuck they do that at?
He really did. He. I mean, I knew there was something there. And
I was John Stockton on that shit, like three times.
You was John Stockton, but he wasn't motherfucking Karl Malone. He was Mark Eaton's punk ass.
Yep. And the worst part is I could have popped a three, like, for I'm like, no, go ahead, get that shit.
Hey.
I mean, hey, John, I listen to the show all the time, and I used to feel sorry for you. I never tried to call in and harass you because people kill you, but you messed up some pussy after on the air yesterday. They talked shit about you, so you went back for a rerun, and you still ain't getting none. Do you know what you was coming for?
No, and really, I thought that that was really on the table, and Jude did really set me up. No, but at some point, when you're out with a person, and then it's clear that they're not just feeling it anymore, I just...
Womp, womp, womp.
Fine.
Drew, hit that button on him. You hit him on all the time.
Let me find that shit. Hold on 1 second. Yeah, here you go,
sad
man.
Trombone. Yeah. Hey, but as with
hey,
everything...
Camille, don't give him another shot. Don't give him another shot. He blew it. Get your ass to somebody else, because John's scared of pussy.
Yeah, let me. Yeah, actually, we should have put Camille on the other side and lock her. Yeah, there you go, Camille. Do you think that's it for John, Camille?
What? Sorry.
Do you think that's his John's only chance? Those last two, or did he? Does it?
You know, I honestly think that if John had had maybe two more glasses of wine, I think John definitely, you know, would be all over it.
Oh
no, it'd be
God.
Just no fucks given anymore. You know, and John is a complete gentleman, but I think that he needs maybe two or three more glasses of wine to just really tap into that carnal side.
Would you cool with the wine shit? I had two glasses of wine like a normal fucking adult. I'm not
He's an alcoholic. That was the last girl said you
normal
did.
Normal fucking adults closed the deal.
Lamar's still here. Wonderful.
well, hey, I mean... For a long time, I thought John was all about gin. So when he ordered wine, I was like, oh.
He's going to take it easy.
Yeah. Why shit me so hard on the fucking wine?
Oh, my God, dog.
I bought your wine. What's this?
Wow. You get a star for that. Yeah. Look at you, gentleman.
Eight
bought her a glass of wine.
$8 glass of wine, man.
Calm down. Fucking.
And I actually bought dinner, which I never buy anything for any man.
You insisted.
I told you that. I bought dinner.
You insisted.
She insisted, man. I said,
are you a fucking... Oh, my God. It just gets worse. The more he talks, it just gets worse. Let's go to Nate in D.C. Go ahead, Nate.
What up, Jude?
What up, Nate?
Hey, normally I'd be feeling bad for dude John, man, because you gotta get on his ass a lot. But I wish I could punch him through the fucking phone right now, bro. How you fucking set up? He literally handed you a vagina, and you said no, thank you. Let me turn this down in the most unmanliest way possible.
I don't see this.
She bought you dinner, bro. You got a fucker.
She bought you dinner.
I don't see this.
And you can say, oh yes, it's the wine. It's the wine. Oh my Jesus Christ, bro. Man,
it was not the wine. Again, for the record, I was not drunk. I had two glasses of wine too. All right, now, but
you need to be drunk to smash a fucking stripper, bro. You don't. Come on, man.
She's a smart stripper too.
Yeah,
she's like smart.
I'm already ready to tear her ass up, and I haven't even seen this motherfucker yet.
At Camille writes. At Camille _ writes.
I got my hands a little full. I'm driving and trying to focus on John's bitch assness, but I can't believe you set his ass up like that and he just slam dunked on the backboard. Like, what the fuck was that?
I did ask her. I did say, hey, do you want to get back? She said, no, what are you going to do?
Just everything
you
did.
What are you
going to
do?
I'm going to fuck your brains out. That's what you say.
There's no world in which I would say that to somebody back home, bro.
Yo, and the thing is like, yo, there was all like where he took her to eat at. There's hobos and bums all over the place. You could have probably just pushed her up into a fucking doorway, and y'all could have just gotten nasty and shit. Nobody would even notice. They're so gone off of fucking dope and shit over there, man. God damn it.
Well, John, bro, I almost can't believe this shit, man. You said you can't believe how you didn't seal the deal. Everyone listening believes how you didn't seal the deal.
You know, I was a little surprised because there was a lot of touching throughout the night. There was a lot of touching.
Jesus Christ.
Lots it was almost like you just stretched it way too long. It was already, like, you guys already had your date.
Yeah, I know.
Should have went home, fucked, and then fed her.
Yeah. Skip the coffee, B. I'm sure you got a coffee, a Keurig at home. Get a fucking cup at the house.
Yeah, I know he stole one of them bitches when we moved. Fucking yeah, exactly. That mother stole one when we moved. Goddamn offices. Kiki in Texas. Go ahead, Kiki.
The word is acquired.
Man, John, you're fucking gay, okay?
I'm not gay. I don't care.
Let me tell you why. Because yesterday, first of all, you talking about your apartment. Fuck your apartment. Y'all was gonna fuck in the woods, okay? And then second of all, mommy. Who fucking drinks wine? What man, grown-ass motherfucking man, should have 2 glasses of wine and don't even, like, what the fuck?
Gets
even,
all tipsy.
I was not tipsy.
Yeah, you got tipsy.
I didn't drink any wine into the table.
Yesterday,
I'm not against wine. It's
like
just,
you
got all...
in the ass.
Yeah.
Yesterday, like, it was not like she wanted to fuck in the ass. Like, you was waiting for her to fuck in the ass. Like, what's wrong with you? She was giving you the pussy. She said, hey...
Kiki, I've had anal sex, and Camille would have agreed to that if, you know, we should have been there. I mean, it may have happened, but for whatever reason, she bailed.
Kiki does bring up a valid point that she was willing to smash you, like, in the dirt, in the woods. So, like...
In theory. I did not test that theory.
She said it, though, and then she said it again on the fucking show, and then, like, you're afraid to take her to your... To your house because your room is messy. Like,
so you,
she already told you she would fuck in the dirt.
All right,
you, like,
okay, all right.
You got to be doing worse. You got to have like a whole troop of roaches living up in your crib for to bum her ass out.
All right. So, if we're leaving here, so you wanted me to say to her, "Hey, let's go back to my place."
I'd be like,
"You wanted
me
to say that?"
I would say, "Let's go get a drink back by my." I would take her to a bar on the way to my house, and then be like, "Hey, let's go back to my crib. And we'll order some fucking Grubhub and do whatever."
Interesting. Okay.
Get some Grubhub. Eat some Grubhub after you worked up a nice appetite from smashing.
Yeah, that's actually not a bad idea.
Yeah.
All
right. You put her in the car. You walk her down. You make sure she's good and safe. She feels like a fucking lady.
Right.
That was quite nice. And then the next day you send her a text. I had a really nice time with you last night.
Sounds to me like I'm dead in the water, though.
I'm surprised that you're not, dude. Like,
No. I think I am. Just based on her answer a moment ago, I think that I'm dead in the water. I think this was another strike.
I mean, clearly this was a... She all but fucking spelled it out.
She was very specific yesterday.
And I had shit to do yesterday, too. I just went home. I didn't do shit. I went home and got in a fight with the lady in the ice cream parlor. I ain't had shit to do.
I think
she was throwing a vibe at me. I was like, you know
she
what,
was.
Though?
I saw
yeah,
that.
I know.
I saw that.
I know. And I was like, you know what? Her and John started something. I'm not gonna get in the way of this one.
I did use one of the dick pills, though.
And I gave him a dick pill because I was like, he might be nervous. So I did that.
Man, those work like you wouldn't believe.
Alex in North Carolina.
Hey, fellas.
Hey there, man.
Good fucking day to some of us, anyway. So here's the thing. Two things, all right? Number one, it's like we gave you the box with the model airplane inside and all the pieces were there, and we came back and you fucking ate the cardboard box and the pieces are shoved in your fucking ears, dude. Okay, so now what happens when you're a child and you do bad things, you need to be disciplined. So right now, everybody in that studio needs to come up with a fucking punishment for your failure. So you're gonna get it, you son of a bitch.
You
damn
did.
It. I'm so disappointed, dude.
I don't view this as a failure.
He's right, yo. Like, I didn't even think about, like, you let Shade 45 down, you let the All Out Show down, you let Eminem down, you let Paul Rosenberg down, you let Def Jam Records down, you let everybody motherfucking down.
Steve Burkle didn't even fuck up this bad, and that guy was fucking shit up every day.
Yeah, you gotta have, like, You gotta be like Steve Urkel and turn into Estevan or whatever his sexy name was. You need a sexy alter ego. Just they got the Pink Floyd channel still. You let that motherfucking channel down.
You walk in there next time, Johnny. You say hello. My name is Juan.
Right.
I love you.
By the way, even though I think that I'm kind of dead in the water in this, I do believe based on the foundation that I've laid out here on our next trip, I may be able to turn that around. There's a distinct possibility.
Let's go to Jerome in Birmingham. Jerome!
Not dead yet.
Jerome, you're a bitch!
I'm not a bitch! I spoke to a lovely woman!
Hey, John, shut the fuck up, John. You a bitch, man. You need to listen, man. I think you allergic to pussy. She laying the pussy out of you on the powder. Why the fuck do you keep fucking up, man?
It's not a fuck up.
I've never been as fucking disappointed in your bitch ass, man. You acting like a bitch, man.
We were just sitting there talking, having what apparently was too much wine, but I was two glasses for the record.
How long did you spend at the fucking Chinese restaurant?
Well, I mean, so again, there was an appetizer thing happening, and then so it was like an hour and a half maybe, and then
John, shut the fuck up, John. You doing too much talking and not enough fucking, man.
Yeah, it was already like, there.
Like, he seemed willing at one point.
How you cool with going this long without pussy?
That's a very good question.
You were embarrassed of your house, and that's why you didn't take her home at first, and you had to get some drinks in you.
Well, first of all, the apartment thing was a factor. Not a huge one, but a factor. And I did say, hey, we'll have to clean it up first.
We'll have to clean it up first? You're going to have to clean my house before I put dick in
you. Well, no, I'll just have her sit out there
first
on the porch.
Buy me some Chinese food, then clean my house, and then I'll fucking give you some mediocre dick, and I can't eat pussy because my lips are gone. Sweet.
Are you a bitch, man?
No, it's not a bitch thing. You're hanging out with somebody, you're chatting, and then some don't work out. This one didn't work out.
Oh my God!
By the way, I really thought it was at one point, and then you know, especially when she had her leg on my leg. I was like,
oh my God! She gave you like all these signals.
Look at that! Look at that leg.
John, you might be gay for real, bro.
I'm not.
I don't think he's gay. A gay guy would have fucked her. A gay guy would have picked up those signals.
They were pretty.
Let's be real. A gay guy would have smashed.
But again, I kind of just spelled it out.
You're just asexual.
No, I'm not. I've had sex.
You ain't sexual.
You a bitch.
Bitch sexual. I'm not a bitch for this. I refuse to accept that. Not a bitch for this one.
Hey, all right, man. Yo, Jerome, people just lined up to talk to John. Well, you getting fucked today, huh, John?
Yes, this is a nice consolation.
Let everybody else go in, man. Yeah. You're a bitch, bro.
Yeah. Oh, it was either you fuck her or the crowd was going to fuck you. It was one of those deals. Did you realize that? Did you realize that when you're out with her? Like, if you didn't close the deal, that you were going to get ate up today?
Of course. Of course. The moment it happened. There was that moment of clarity where you just paused for a second and like, okay. Well, the pressure's off there, but I got another problem tomorrow.
I literally walked by and slid him a full pack of Viagra because I was like, I know he's going to be nervous after all of this shit. Like, let me just make sure I don't want to hear no fucking bad Yelp reviews on John.
Dude, my dick was throbbing in time with my heart. I was stunned, man. What the fuck are those?
They're the dick pills, man.
Oy.
Oh, my God, dude.
I used one of the pocket pussies.
You fucked a pocket pussy.
I did.
Oh, what a... Just, it gets worse. Like,
why not?
As it goes on, it just gets worse.
You gave me the pills. I was just like, hey, let's see what happens. Let's see what this is all about.
We need to take those away from him so that he doesn't have options. Go ahead, David in Richmond.
John, God damn it. I am so disappointed. Oh, my God. I thought yesterday was bad, but somehow you managed to top it today.
You even pissed off and the like, gay dudes.
I listened to the entire show yesterday till like 2 a.m., and I just got off work hoping that I would hear some good news from you.
Hey.
And as soon as I heard you that you didn't feel the deal, I just yelled out, God damn it, you bitch.
Well, David, it was kind of laid out for me there. I will grant you that. But you must have been out on a date where it's just suddenly... I mean, I wouldn't even call it... I guess it was. I don't know. But the point is, at some point, you just like, okay, this is not going to work out. I mean, it happens.
My homeboy don't. Yeah, I'm listening. My homeboy don't is at home, back home, listening.
Oh, man.
And he said, you definitely a bitch.
I am not a bitch for this. People strike out once in a while.
He's afraid of real pussy. That's what he said. He said, you afraid of real... And he put all... Capital's most definitely a bitch.
Oh, just to
and don't yell know, at me. Don't know, because we used to slay chicks.
I think another person would have handled it differently. I will admit that. I can see that very clearly.
Oh my God, man, I'm just hold up, Lonnie. Go ahead, Lonnie.
John, man, I'm usually on your side. I work with special ed kids. I work with at-risk youth. And it's like, you know, lately in the sports we've been seeing, they've been putting the Down syndrome kid out there, letting him run the football, or putting the kid on the free throw line and giving him the free shot. This is what happened, John. You were that Down syndrome kid that they gave the football.
and you dropped it.
I did not drop it.
Special ed kid that they put on the free throw line.
That is not true.
The team got out of the way.
I was out there in the game.
John.
I was in the game.
No. They put you on the free throw line. They moved out of the way.
They gave you the football and you ran up into the stands, you dumb motherfucker.
Yeah, you ran the other way.
You ran into the parking lot.
You know, admittedly, no one has ever greased the wheels as effectively as you did. And I did. I'll tell you that.
Here's the worst part, Camille.
I'm on your side. I'm like Jude. You're too hard on John. But after this, I'm just like, what? I can't even speak for you anymore, man.
And you know what? The craziest shit, Lonnie. He's better now than he was when he got here 2 years ago, 3 years ago.
That's a very disturbing, disappointing statement. Jude, to hear you say that,
it's a slow build.
Wow, John. I mean, I'm generally on your side, but listen, you're the Down syndrome kid. When
that is not true. Again, I reject that. That wholeheartedly. Okay? I was out there, and then so suddenly she made a decision, and that decision was not to suck my dick, and then so I had to walk away.
When they give me the ball, John, just run. Okay, don't ask questions. Don't question it. Just hold on to the ball and run. When they point it.
When you was hugging on her, like where'd you put your hands?
Waist.
You didn't move them at all?
You know, at some point,
did
I thought
about
it. Did you
grab her ass or anything?
Well, without the kiss, that seemed a little weird. So suddenly, without a kiss,
when did
suddenly,
you eat
I'm
the
just,
dick pill?
When I got home.
Oh, so you got home and just ate the dick pill knowing you wasn't going to get no pussy?
Yeah, I wanted to see what would happen.
Oh, my fucking God. When you was hugging on her, was your dick hard at all, or were you a little excited?
Sure.
So she could have she felt that dick on your leg, on her leg, and just kept hugging you.
Well, I'm not going to sort of drape it over like a.
What'd you do? Do like a make a letter A so she was like far away. Your
a
dick
little
was.
Bit, you know.
Oh, what a bitch!
What?
What a bitch!
That's what
bitch.
People do. Really?
Yo, if you about to if you hugging on a girl and your dick gets hard, throw that shit on her motherfucking leg so she can feel what she's about to get.
Really? You know, I've heard that in jokes. I didn't think people really did that.
Oh, my fucking God. You're on a date, John.
I don't know.
She said, I'm cold. Here's a hug. Camille.
Yes.
What would you have done if John had, like, was hugging on you and you felt his erection? Would you have been offended?
Definitely not. I mean, you know, you got to try it out, you know, before you work with it, you know?
Oh my God!
Absolutely.
So wait a minute. Let me just get this straight, always. Camille. Let me get this straight.
Why are you yelling at her? She bought you Chinese.
Sorry, I know that.
Why are you yelling at Camille? She bought you Chinese food last night.
We had a lovely time together. We spent many hours together.
I know.
And then so
many fruitless hours, and she went home and just was like, really?
So you're telling me that at some point, if my penis was on your leg, you would have liked that?
Yeah. Why not?
Are you being serious?
Yes, I am.
She's
okay.
She's comfortable with her sexuality. She knows what
Definitely.
She wants.
What do you know?
Oh yeah. No, I'm all for like sex like on the fifth date because I'm not trying to waste my time, you know?
Yeah, like, she's out of town.
If things
tonight.
Yeah.
She's gone.
She's flying out of town, dude.
Different time zone.
Like, what are you trying to do? Like, what are you trying to do? Do like fucking 80 hours with her before you put dick to her? Like, what are you doing, man?
Absolutely.
Wes in Atlanta.
Time is precious.
Go ahead, Wes.
John, man, you a special kind of fuckboy.
Hey, I'm not a fuckboy. I'm not taking that for this. This is not a complete
failure. My bad. You right, because you ain't fucking. That's why.
Well, there's not been a lot of fucking recently.
Even fuckboys get some dick. You know what I'm saying? Like, right. Jesus Christ.
Right. How can you cock block yourself in 48 hours? Right.
How do you cock block yourself twice in 48 hours, he wants to know.
The first one was forgivable. This one's a little worse.
You're thinking too much, man.
I mean, that's possible. And by the way, you know, when
you're trying to make a relationship. You're supposed to fuck.
Huh?
End of story.
All right.
What did you jerk off to, by the way?
There was, some porn in like a classroom or something.
Oh, he watches porn, so you do know how to fuck.
No, yo, you didn't hear the part? He dropped her, she dropped him off in the Uber. He went upstairs, ate the dick pill I gave him, and then fucked a pocket pussy to fucking teach her porn. in his dirty room. Did you clean your room yet?
Some of it. I have to move things around. I've got a plan now.
Wes, I'm saying. I'm,
Boy, those pills.
Hey, people be getting on you, man. I'd be like, damn, John got to come through. He got to stop these motherfuckers. But God, every damn time you, I think you at the edge, man, your ass turn around, man. You don't do shit, man. What the fuck is wrong with you, bro?
There is some sex coming in the future. I guarantee it. I can feel it. I can see it on the horizon.
Shut up. Just shut up. Just stop, man.
It's coming.
We literally had two hater lovers in a row, and it has been all hate for like 2 hours. It's done.
Oh my God! All right, man. Damn.
And you're more disappointing than the first hater love it.
Oh, I see.
You're more disappointing than the guy that freestyle rapped to his girlfriend and then she fucked the producer and he still wrote a song about it. You're more disappointing than him.
Yeah, you know, hey.
Camille,
sweetheart,
I appreciate you hanging on. Are you down by the airport? You far away now?
I actually just had lunch with a girlfriend, and I'm flying out in a few hours. Yes.
John, when do you leave here?
Why don't you
hop in the cab and just try to fucking
hop in a cab.
You ain't got no
need some cash.
Jesus Christ, man! I'll try to line that shit up.
All right.
All right, Camille. I appreciate you calling up.
Definitely.
Just out of curiosity, like on a scale from 1 to 10, John had about a 9 chance of smashing the first time y'all hung out, and then yesterday was a bit lower. What's his chances now?
I definitely think the next time that I'm out here on business. I don't think wine will have to be involved. I think wine helped his confidence, definitely. I think maybe we'll have to take like one issue of Penthouse, maybe read some stories to help John to get in the mood, you know?
That's what old people do when they want to molest children. That's, swear to God. That's what old people do when they want to fuck boys. I swear to you, dude. Like, I've heard that story a million times. Like, he brought me in, he gave me a popsicle and showed me a porno magazine and tickled my booty.
She's grooming me. Grooming me for sex.
Yep. That's what she has to do. That's what she has to do to you. You're like a 7-year-old. Oh, my God. Okay, all right, Camille.
Again with the wine, though. What the hell? Fucking 2 glasses.
Bro.
That's normal.
Off that. Yo, really. Thank you, Camille. Appreciate you.
Fucking A.
Here, hang up. I don't even, because you, just hang. I'm going to say some shit. Thank you. Thanks. Thanks, Camille. We'll talk to you later. Bro.
Yeah.
You can't just keep doing this, man. Like, she's just too bad, like, for nobody to fucking, like, you just ruining it. Not just for you. You're ruining it for everybody.
You know, I got to tell you.
I'm just think about it like that. Not only did you not smash, I didn't smash either because you didn't smash.
And I think
I yelled at the ice cream lady yesterday. That's what I did. I yelled at the motherfucking ice cream lady. I don't know what she looked like. You were a black lady with clear glasses. If you're listening right now, fuck you still. Fuck you still, ice cream lady. I don't know the name of the ice cream shop, but suck my dick and I'm glad your door is broken.
Oh, man.
Fuck you. Yeah, I went and that's what I did yesterday. I got argued with the ice cream lady and there was a girl that was interested in both of us, and you fucking blew it.
I am very confident if you left here with her, you would have had sex with her. 100%. 100%.
John, that's like saying water's wet.
All right, fine. Fine.
John, that is like saying water's wet and the sky is blue. No motherfucking shit, man.
Yeah, but you would have said, hey, we're going back to my place, or something like that.
You could have said the same shit.
Well, I will next time.
You could have said the same shit, John.
I learned.
You was like,
I learned from my mistakes.
You literally drove the opposite direction of your motherfucking house.
Right.
And then took her to fucking coffee afterwards. Yeah. This ain't Harry Met Sally, bro. Like, take her to the motherfucking crib. Throw some dick on her ass. Eat your little dick pill. Throw some dick on her ass. Rep for the fucking show.
Yeah, she seems a little annoyed with me.
Gee, I wonder fucking why, John. You wasted her whole fucking trip in California. You don't think she had better shit to do than fucking treat you to Chinese food?
I guess not.
And watch you get wasted.
Two glasses! Yeah, no, give it to me. Two glasses.
Bro, this is the second time I heard about this shit. The last time was that Mexican chick, and she was like, he came over to my place, and he got all drunk and just laid on the couch.
That's a whole different scenario, and I've got answers all over the place.
All right, man, y'all listen to All Out Show. Let's play some music. Come on back.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
All right, y'all. What's up, y'all? How you guys doing? I was going to say some shit, and then I just forgot mid-fucking syllable. You want to follow us? Follow at All Out Show. We do little fucking polls and shit like that and take pictures of the artists. And when we play Black, White, or Other, we post the pictures of the people that were in Black, White, or Other. Or you can follow me as well, at One More Jude. Shit, while you're at it, follow Shade45 too. At Shade45. At One More Jude, I got the lean, mean meme game. Tomorrow's White People Wednesday. Go to @onemorejude.com. Also, coming this Christmas is the Hummingbird, fucking K Fox. He's a wine blender, an award-winning wine blender. And Tristan Eaton, who's a fucking beast of artist. You can look him up on YouTube or on Instagram, Tristan Eaton. We're doing a three-way collaboration, wine. Brand new hardback with Tristan Eaton's Hummingbird and the Calibri red wine. You know what Calibri means? Fucking Hummingbird in Italian. Baraka. For Christmas. I think there's only 1,500 bottles. Only 1,500 bottles. And you can't get it yet, but I'm telling you to be ready. To be ready. And whoever had pre-ordered that book first, you guys are going to get first shot at that shit. Because I appreciate day one motherfuckers. Go to onemorejude.com. For all the info on damn near everything. And coming up next, John is going to tell you about, what are we talking about, buttholes? Butt sex?
Lots of butt sex.
We're talking about anal sex. Yeah. Anal sex and some homeless people. The homeless in San Francisco. This fuck, yo. Cali's turning into a fucking shithole, dude. I am telling you, Cali is turning into a fucking shithole. I'm watching. I've been here for damn near 20 years. It's just getting worse and worse. They should just let the citizens have like a samurai sword one day and just go out. Wow, wow, wow. Bums and tourists. Bums and tourists. Like Fruit Ninja. All right, let's play some music. Come on back.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you. And now, it's time for News from the Chin with John Z. Matthews.
The Metro out of the UK, this online publication, they have this article here with 9 women talking about what anal sex really feels like. So they dug deep.
I asked the one girl, she said it just feels like you're pooping. But then the poop keeps going back inside of you. And then it feels like, oh, you're about to poop again. And then it goes, no, I'm afraid of the water. And it goes back inside of you again. Over and over again.
Does that sound pleasurable?
No.
Okay. It doesn't.
No.
It sounds unpleasant.
It does. And now I'm going to talk science to you cats. Like, I guess the fucking, like the dude's version of the G-spot is inside their butthole. So it feels different for fellas than for girls because they don't have a prostate. That's why you can, you know, identify as a chick all you want and still get prostate cancer. Sidebar shit. And only dudes have those.
I do not see a day when I accept something in my ass. I mean, even like a hot lady, like, hey, can I put this in there? No.
I hear you, man.
Yeah, I don't see that.
I fucking, yeah, it's not my deal.
I don't think so.
But that shit happened to me when I was in a massage. I didn't even know it. I was so relaxed. I never went back to her again. I was like, I put that in your butt. I was like, what? Yeah.
No, thank you.
Yeah. Fucking, I think her name was either Brenda or Diane or some shit like that. I did not go back to her again. After fucking. But that shit didn't bump me out as much because I've had all those fucking ass problems. So doctors have been fucking.
That's right.
And I got this Armenian motherfucker. He don't even shut the door. Like, he'll just be like, lay down, take your pants off. And he'll have the door open. Nurses will be walking by. Eating fucking Armenian cookies and shit. And the last time, and he don't even like put lube. He just jabs. I'm like, ah.
Man.
Fucking, yeah. And we don't even got like a 5K for hemorrhoids. There's not even a 5K run for fucking hemorrhoid survivors.
Have you had a bona fide prostate exam where a doctor goes in there with something to really go deep?
Nah, but like once we're getting to the age where you're supposed to.
I know.
But I feel like I'm not going to do that. I didn't like that other shit, man. I didn't like that shit. When I got in the goddamn car accident. Fucking. They fingered my butt then too. When I broke my neck.
They were going in that direction?
It's me and the homies. I'm not even gonna throw them out there. I think I name them in the fucking book. So if you want to read fucking Hyena, this is in the book. We're like, we get in a car wreck and they make us like, I'm real fucked up, clearly, because I had broke my neck. And my other homies was like, you know, bleeding out the head and shit. And I just remember hearing my homeboy saying, "What are you doing? What are you doing? Get that out my ass!" Yo! And I'm like, and I'm fucking sitting there, broke neck, laughing like ha ha ha. And then they come to me, and I'm like, "Whoa, no shit, don't!" Like, "Why are you doing this? Why? Whoa, no, don't do that in my butt." And they're like, "We're checking for bleeding." I'm like, "I'm with that. Nah, I ain't bleeding. We good."
No kidding.
Fuck yeah, man.
I would not have expected that.
Me neither. I was like, I broke my neck. Why are you fucking with my asshole right now? C1, C2, C3, hangman's fracture. And I'm walking. Hey, they killed that Jewish motherfucker. And I wouldn't know. I'm just saying. Epstein, or whatever his name is. They murdered him. Somebody had his ass murdered.
Sure.
Are you fucking kidding me, John? That's why I never trust you.
Look, CNN said it was a fucking suicide. And if CNN says it's a fucking suicide, then it's a fucking suicide.
I've not seen a smart person yet out there supporting that idea. I mean, it's a fun theory.
Are you fucking kidding me, dude, right now? For real.
It was a little disappointing that it happened. Which is pretty dog. Mildly. No. It was.
Dog. That motherfucker. They killed. Cameras just stopped working. New guard. They take out his bunkie. His cellmate's gone. Put new guards on that shit.
Typically,
they're sleeping, like all of that shit. Come on, man.
The simplest explanation.
Yeah, they killed him. That's the simplest explanation is he got murdered because a bunch of rich motherfuckers was like, nah, you ain't finna bury us.
A lot of weird stuff happens in prisons all the time.
John.
All the time, man. It's a lot worse.
This is why I have no faith in you right now.
I look for the truth. I'm not on Reddit saying, well, that's a great theory.
Even the way his bones was broken. It was very, very hard to break your bones in that way. You'd have to be hung from something higher to break your bones in that way.
Hmm. We'll see.
Doctors say that shit. All you gotta do is just pay off one medical examiner. Yeah, suicide. How much you think it costs them to pay them rich motherfuckers to pay him off?
All right, so let's say it did happen. Now, I mean, now that he's dead, nothing really has changed. It's not as though he's going to say, oh, yeah, I did it. I'm guilty. I mean, what?
He was going to, that motherfucker was going to be singing like Sinatra.
Fuck
he was
no.
going to be singing like motherfucking Sinatra. Why? Throwing all those rich people under the bus.
Why? How would that benefit him?
Just shave some time off of his shit, and he's probably like, yo, if I'm going down for this shit, everybody's going down for this shit. Like, y'all not going to protect me? Y'all own these jails. You're not going to protect me? Come on.
He was facing real time. Real time. He was going to die there. So, I mean, he was just looking at death anyway. He said, fuck it. I'm out.
Let's say he did. Let's say he did want to kill himself.
Right.
There was still all this negligence, purposeful negligence, where the big people in charge wanted him to fucking kill himself.
I mean, CNN told me. It's not hard to
read like five different. Man, I can't even look at him.
Oh.
You really think that this kid fucker wasn't finna sing?
No, I don't. I don't. All the information's out there anyway. Some of it.
That's why they killed his ass.
Hmm.
They was desperate as fuck. You know they was desperate as fuck.
Who's they?
The fucking rich motherfuckers that really run shit. That you don't even see. There's like a group of rich motherfuckers that we don't even see, man.
Oh, I know
they're off doing shit, bro. Yeah. They're so far away from us. We're just little ants to them. They elephants, bro.
And he was definitely one of them. What a shady character.
He was some sort of financial advisor,
but he didn't have any clients. He had one. I mean, he was probably extorting that guy. It's all weird.
Yeah, man, he was setting up fucking orgies with children, bro. Fucking weird. That's what happens when you get that rich. You get so fucking rich, like, just nothing is good enough anymore. So now they're like, oh, let's fuck a kid. That's the one thing I haven't done yet.
It's fun.
Like, I already went to the Bahamas, like, 40 times. Anyway, tell me about this anal sex and women.
All right. So here we go.
Tell me about anal and women.
The first lady is with you. She's saying here it was like backwards poo.
Ha, ha, ha. She wasn't with me. She was with my homegirl that told me about that shit. Let's not get it twisted.
Sorry. But she didn't like it, so she bailed on that. This one said, I think it feels good because it feels wrong.
Yeah, there's a nasty element.
Dirty.
That's like me and fucking hookers, man.
Dirty sex.
Like, I cannot bust. It's so hard for me to bust with, like, regular chicks just because I'm used to fucking, but then I get a hooker. Splat. Just because I'm like, you're fucking disgusting, and I'm disgusting, and this is disgusting.
Do you whisper that in her ears?
Nah, I just think that in my fucking head. Like, look at me, I'm a piece of shit buying pussy. Look at you, you're a piece of shit selling pussy. We're both pieces of shit. Rawr.
And then bang.
Splat. Fuck out of here. Takes a little longer with the fucking, with the hand job, ladies. And sometimes it'll get to the point where I'm feeling bad. Because you see him like working up a sweat and shit. I'm like, sorry, man. The last one I was on LSD, she's like, oh, you take so long. You high. You on drug. I was like, how you know? She, oh, your teeth, they grinding.
Oh, man.
Ooh, Hunter S. Thompson. She straight up dropped Hunter S. Thompson on me. I was fucking impressed. I was like, wow, dude. Oh, you a Hunter S. Thompson. I was like, give me a number. Do you do fucking, house calls? Yeah.
Now I've got some lesbians here saying it was about getting off on the power.
Oh yeah,
something that never occurs to me during sex. Seems like it would with you, but
see. That was when I was really fat and shy, and I would like wouldn't go all the way hard trying to go at girls, and I wasn't direct. And then I kind of got this, then I started losing weight and girls were noticing me, and then I started resenting them. And so there was this, like, I had, like, a two-year spat period of just anger fucking. Like, I was just trying to fuck every one of her hoes. I was mad at, like, this girl had nothing to do with it, but I'm like, I'm mad because Laura with the fat ass didn't like me back in the seventh grade. You know what I mean? So I'm going to take it out on you.
I've heard about that hate fucking.
Hate fucking is kind of different. It's like if you really just don't like that person in general. Yeah. My shit was I was angry that chicks didn't like me, and then fucking now they do, and I'm like, so I was just trying to hit every hole. And then when I saw them with their man, with their new man, because I wouldn't wife them. I was seeing with their new man. I'd be like, I fucking hit every hole. I'm like a golfer. I'm a Tiger Woods on your girl whole body. Tiger Woods her whole frame. Then I go buy some motherfucking Hilfiger or Nautica from the Marshalls or some shit.
Have you ever given
at the mall?
Given a woman poppers for this kind of thing? They, someone talks about like they went down to the store to get some poppers.
I was doing poppers at the crib just solo. Not a great buzz. Not a good buzz. But I guess it's supposed to open up your butthole.
That's what they're saying.
I didn't check. I was just sitting there fucking smoking black and miles watching movies and had the poppers. That was when you could walk in and just like, that was when all the Sikhs and shit owned the porn stores in New York. Shout out to my man Brad. He showed up to our show in New York just doing tons of poppers. I think there's a picture out there where he's like, he's got the poppers up and it's me and Sear and him with his poppers. I think he's, yeah. I ain't do no poppers. I don't like them. They give me a headache. But if you're trying to fuck your girl, give her some poppers. M drops a line about it.
Oh, that's right.
He's like, this. My face blush from doing too much Rush or some shit. Rush is the name of the popper. My face is like red blush from popping too much Rush.
Well, because they do warn you here, having anal sex, it can be incredibly painful if you're not ready for it, and it can even tear your thin, delicate skin inside the anus.
That's how you get fucking AIDS.
Ugh.
That's how you get AIDS. Yeah.
No,
you want to get AIDS?
I do not.
You go get butt fucked by someone with AIDS. That's going to get you some AIDS, bro. Oh, man. You want a dose of AIDS?
Here's how you do it.
That's it. That's how you get yourself. That's how you get your AIDS on. I know shit. Like, I've said this before. Like, that's when you know you do that. That's when I know I'm fucking too much, when I'm just trying to hit in the asshole. I'm like, dude, you need to slow down.
When's the last time you had anal?
Shit. With this little Ecuadorian chick. Yeah. She wanted it. We was in the middle of the session. I was fine. She was like, fuck me in my ass. I was like, let's go.
Last time I brought it up to somebody, no go. Not into it.
The worst is when you're doing it like for a minute, you're doing it for a while, and then you start to smell something. You look down, and you're like, oh, man. And this is what you do. This is what you do, fellas. If you want to continue getting anal from women, you do not say anything about it. You will be like, all right, let's chill. And you go to the bathroom, you peel that shit off, and you go back with a warm washcloth and wipe her fucking shit and throw that thing away and fucking do not say that she shit all over your penis.
Ugh. I will. Because
you're going to ruin it for the next guy. Sometimes they don't even know. It's so far up in them, but you're gone for a minute. It's just loosening shit up, and then blam. And here's a little... I don't know. There's something like... Other people's poop always smells worse than your own poop, no matter what.
Yeah, I actually don't mind mine.
See? That's what I'm saying. But you get another person's poop on you. You're like, fuck, son. That's not my poop. My butt, my nose is like, that's not your poop. Yeah. All right, give me another fucking story.
If you're using your smartphone at work during a break, you are screwing yourself up. It leads to mental fatigue. And so, according to these studies, people just couldn't focus after they were on their phones screwing around. And you're just always spun up.
That's why, people will be like, why don't you shoot an IG live while you're doing this shit? And it's like, I cannot concentrate on doing a show and doing an IG live. I just can't. Doesn't happen. If it does happen, I'm not holding that phone. Did you notice that every study that we have about phone, we have yet to have a study and be like, you know what? These phones, not that bad. Pretty good. Did you ever notice that shit?
Everything across the board has been.
Like, we not even, what's that, five? Is it 5K or 5G? G5? What's the
5G?
5G? Fun to just remix children's cells structure and turn them into fucking, like, give them problems. Like, this ain't the movies where you get your shit, your cell structure remixed, and then you become Wolverine or something. You just fucking die early. Straight up. Like, you get bit by a toxic spider out here, you just lose a leg. It's like you don't turn into Spider-Man. You turn into fucking Wobbly Man with the wheelchair access shit. Don't buy into them motherfucking them comic books, man. All right, what else you got for me? Yeah, this just then, these phones will fucking kill you. What's that shit? What's the thing that creates stress? Cortisol. Like, these phones give you cortisol. They pump your cortisol shits. And especially, like, if you're on there arguing with some fucking stranger, you're not gonna make any. You're not changing anyone's mind. Like, I've never dropped some points to somebody, like, showing them some fucking, like, straight up facts with the link to the facts. And no one's ever been like, oh, thanks, man. I never thought about it like that. Thanks for giving me this new information that I can come up with a different worldview. No one, not yet. Just fucking, phones are fucking, they're good for ordering food. That's it. Sunday, I ordered Grubhub 3 times. I didn't fucking leave my couch.
What was that, $70?
I think it was damn near $100. Because, you know, they run it up. Like, I ordered Jersey Mike's or some shit like that.
Jersey Mike's?
Yeah, man, I just wanted, like, a fucking sandwich. But I was tired as fuck. I've been up since fucking 2 in the morning your time to try to get out here. So I'm just like, fucking Jersey Mike's. And then, so, you, yeah. Taxed the fuck out of me. I'm like, god damn. Sidebar shit, that fucking club, the Jersey Mike's club sandwich, pretty fucking good.
Sure.
Yeah, not bad. All right, go ahead. So, where else are you going to tell me?
If you have a Mercedes, now this is over in Europe, but this sort of privacy invasion is creeping all over the world.
Oh, it's over.
But so in the Mercedes, they're caught up in this situation because they've got location sensors fitted to most new vehicles in Europe, and they're used in the event of a crash. But they are now activating the trackers to help people repossess cars. So they'll...
Well, they had that shit you could buy for your shit called LoJack.
Sure. Yeah, absolutely.
Well, but this is going to help the dealer, like, come get your car if you're not paying.
Yeah. I mean, this is not... I mean...
That just seems logical. Like, this is everything you sign up for, guys. There's a good and there's a bad. You like, you got OnStar? That's awesome. They'll tell you where the nearest fucking gas station is. They'll also tell people where the fuck your car is parked and how to come get you.
OnStar, is that even still around?
Yeah.
Is it really?
Okay. Yeah. I let my shit, I try to cancel it. My shit came free with OnStar. I was like, I don't want OnStar. I already got a phone tracking me. I don't want y'all tracking me. Fucking OnStar. Whatever, bro.
But, I mean, would you agree this kind of sucks? That, I mean, sure, you should.
Yeah, I agree, it fucking sucks.
Okay.
Yeah, but and then on the flip side, like, when people get their cars repossessed, I don't feel sorry for them. I don't feel bad for you if you got your car repoed. Like, spend within your means. Be a grown-up. And repo men are fucking dicks sometimes. And I've seen like cats like try to get some shit out the hood, and like the whole neighborhood will come out and just be laying on the car and stuff, and they just like give up. They're like, fuck it. But what is that gonna do? That's just gonna make it harder down the road for somebody from your neighborhood to get a fucking car. They'll be like, oh yeah, we sold a car to somebody from your neighborhood, and then he didn't pay, and then everybody from that neighborhood laid on the fucking car. So we couldn't even get our fucking shit back.
Really?
I'm just saying that you don't think there's fucking consequences of people's actions?
Yeah, it spreads.
Yeah, motherfucker. I was telling you that shit. I think wasn't I talking to you about, like, I knew some kid that His old man was in that shit. And he has so many Jordans. Jordans and speakers. Because they were repoing out of Flint.
Wow.
And it was dangerous as fuck. They had to come in at like 6 in the morning, like that perfect time when ain't nobody, like when the dope boy stops. And it just depends, because if there's a factory, like cats are, the dope boys would be selling at 6 in the morning to serve the fucking first shifters. But so you got to find that sweet spot. They would go in and get shot at and shit. Don't take my car. Like, bitch, this is the bank's car. You owe money on it.
So, yeah. As you know, up in San Francisco, they've got a huge homeless problem. But, it's just out of control now.
It's fucking, it is. I was just talking about this on my live. We need to look to the Asian countries to see what they're doing with their homeless people. I suggest that we get a big stick, a long stick with a net on that bitch, and have a homeless catcher. Because they're not going to come in on their own. They're crazy and shit a lot of times. And if they're not crazy, then we can help them along and fucking get them on the straight and narrow. I think we were talking about it yesterday. It was fucking crazy 15 years ago, and now. Yeah, 30%. And like they're over there. They're like they're fucking neck and neck with Bangladesh for fucking people shitting in the goddamn street.
Well, they are referring to this as like sort of a third world country situation.
And it's such a and then you got this thing where it's like all these rich tech motherfuckers came in there and they're running the rents up.
Yeah.
But a lot of people are blaming the rents for the homeless people, but just I'm sure there's a lot of people that went homeless because the rent got too fucking high. But in my experience, and this is just anecdotal, this is just me walking around in Los Angeles, I don't see a lot of fucking like non-crazy, sober people that are homeless. You know what I mean? They're usually fucking yelling at some. You're yelling at some invisible shit or fucking just gone needled up. Fucking faded as shit.
Yeah. Some lady wandered to my apartment last night.
She wandered into your apartment last night?
Yep.
You get some pussy?
I did not.
Oh, God fucking damn.
She was fucking whacked out, and then she looked at me, and then she said something. She was just rambling like a crazy person, and then I realized, this lady's in my fucking apartment. I'm a little high, but not that high. And then...
That's why you a bitch. That's the difference between you and me.
What am I gonna do? Run at her?
That when I woke up to someone in my apartment, I wasn't like, what are you doing? I just said, fucking rushed his ass. Like, ah! And like, wasn't a good fighter. I'll be the first one to tell y'all, not a good fighter. Had some heart, though. Had some heart. No skills. Swung like an orangutan. I was like, you motherfucker. Like, if he was anything besides a tweaker, I probably would have got my ass whooped. But I just grabbed his head and I just smashed it into every fucking thing possible on the way out. It was like, bing, bong, bing, bing, bong, bing. There was that one point where I literally turned him just so I could run his ass into the cupboard. I was like, blam, boom. Had him outside wailing on him and shit. You over here, just some fucking tweaked out bum lady. And you're like, what's going on here? Didn't even get your dick sucked.
No. Well, you should have seen her, though. You would not want that around your cock. I just looked at her and I said, hey, you're not supposed to be here. And then I stood up and then she, she's kind of left. It was weird, though, dude.
Hey, miss, you are not supposed to be here. This is my place. Damn, man. I thought that was going to be over. I thought people were going to stop violating your space once you got your own shit. Nope. Bums heard about you. The dog told the bums about your the dog told the bums about your ass.
I start locking my door.
Yo, and shout out, like, look, man, if you're fucking really down on your luck, fucking homeless person that like just was like some vet that went crazy or something, like or whatever, my heart goes out to y'all cats, but people don't like you for a reason. And it's cause you're fucking trashing places, shitting all over the place, taking pisses on things, and constantly begging. Like, how many shopping carts of shit do you need? All right, tell me some good news.
And now, time for good news.
Well, this person isn't begging, but she needed some help. And so, well,
oh, John, now, love John. We
a community. It we takes was a like, village.
How long? We went what? Like 2 months without a begging? Without a begging, feel good.
We had a good long.
We had a good. We had a long run.
There's nothing wrong with
we
community.
We had a long run. John was like stuck on like old people's birthdays and shit for a while.
Everyone loves the.
Yeah, he was all on the old people's birthdays. Yeah, married couples and
110 years young.
You just had to fucking. We're, now I got to hear about someone getting some free shit.
There's gee, nothing wrong with community.
Gee, I wonder who likes free shit, John.
This is out of Alabama.
That's your whole. He's wearing a shirt that was given to him.
Yeah.
Shout out to Estevan. And the crazy shit was is he's got it inside out.
Yeah. Well, I mean, some days I wear it normally, inside out. Other days, just to change it up a little bit.
Just take all the shirts that fit you, in the thing, so you don't have to keep wearing the same shirt and right. Flipping it inside out.
I got it.
Your fucking
fine.
Dusty, musty
fine.
Ass.
Fine, I got it.
All and right. the illest shit John can do, John will take a black shirt and look like it came from the 70s. It'll look like a concert tee from the motherfucking 70s. If you want your shit, like, yeah, if you're trying to, like, sell used clothes and want to make that shit look vintage, just loan it to John for 1 week. And that shit will come back looking vintage as fuck.
Put it through the ringer.
Like, right now I'm rocking the old school Luther Vandross concert tee. Crushing that shit. It's supposed to be kind of beat up and, like, worn in. But it literally took me fucking 12 years to get to this point. John's shirt, like, just give me some shea butter. just a dab of shea butter.
Gotta keep them clean.
All right, tell me the fucking right. Good news.
All right, so this lady,
all right,
her name is Randa Ragland, and she's been going through some tough times. Her son is special, whatever you want to.
He touched by an angel. He's got some. Well, he's just touched.
But then also, he just got cancer, so he's got a whole scene.
God damn.
And so, but their yard was getting a little overgrown. She was not focusing on that. And then
she had other shit on her plate.
Some dick sent her an anonymous note just saying that she's bringing down the property value.
Which she is.
I guess.
I mean, she is.
I know.
She is.
I know. But so then she posted this on Facebook just to say, hey, you know what? You never know what someone's going through. Just, you know, don't send anonymous notes to your neighbors to fuck with them a little bit. The community came together, took care of her lawn.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Look, man, that guy shouldn't have put that anonymous note. He should have fucking knocked on the door and talked to her like a real fucking person.
Hey,
what's going on with you? Your yard looks a little crazy. What's going on?
But,
and then if there was no reason, then he could be like, well, look, man, you fucking up the property value, so I need you to get on your J-O-B.
So I've got her talking about the community here for a second.
I was here.
Okay.
I'm in amazement. I'm still in shock. I don't have a big family, and my mom is gone, my dad is gone, my brother's gone, so this means a lot. It really does.
Kid about to be gone pretty soon.
No. He's gonna pull
just
through.
Just playing, bro.
I know.
He's gonna make. I wouldn't have made that joke if he wasn't gonna make it. The kid looks fucking great. Kid looks great.
Wine. So of course there is a GoFundMe if you want to search for it.
Of course there's a fucking GoFundMe.
Hey,
what does she need a fucking GoFundMe for?
Well, cancer's expensive.
Hey.
I mean,
don't he got Obamacare or some shit like that? Or they got rid of? I don't even know what's the deal with that.
Oh, I'm sure she's covered in some.
Look, man, just take them in and don't pay the bill like half these motherfuckers do. It only stays on your record for 7 years. Then
really?
They get rid of it. Yeah, just dodge them. Fucking any unknown phone call, avoid. But that's cool, yo. They're gonna GoFundMe for you. What we're gonna allow you to Google that shit. He's a fucking. The goal's $25,000 and he's at $23,800. So he'll make it. Chin up, young pup. You're going to get this shit. And usually them cancer survivors, they go extra hard because they know how close they have looked at death. And it makes them fucking go harder.
By the way, the kid's name is Jackson.
Jackson?
Spelled with an X.
I hate that fucking name.
Oh, man. Jackson with an X.
Well, whatever. It's not like... It's Jackson reminds me of, like, yuppies' children. Like, Jackson.
Oh.
Come here, Jackson. Got the gluten-free crackers for you, Jackson.
And they run up with some Crocs and shit. You're like, fuck this kid. All right. Good for the kid. Chin up, man. You're going to get through this, little man. And shout out to the lady.
Randa Ragland.
Because she ain't had no time to fucking take care of shit. There you go. All right. Guess what, John?
Yeah.
That's the news.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
Yo, that was it. That was the show. Shout out to Oscar from Oxnard. Shout out to fucking Oxnard while we're at it. That feels like real LA. Not here. Not here with. Let's see. Is Keenan from LA?
Colorado.
We got two LA cats. We got two. Alex and Chris are natives, LA natives. That's more than most shows. I'm Michigan. I'm one of the few motherfuckers on Shade 45 actually from Michigan. Imagine that shit. Still repping that shit, what? Still repping that shit, what? Chris on the boards. Keenan, associate producer. Handles the fucking all the All Out Show social media shit. Thank you. John does production and does the nudes. News. And he sends some nudes, if you ask him nicely. And Alex runs things. Hop on my shit at One More Jude for Instagram, at All Out Show, and onemorejude.com if you're kind of curious about me. A lot of people just listen, they don't know what I look like. And then when they see, they're surprised. They're like, who's that handsome young devil? Who's that pink motherfucker? All right, man, tune in tomorrow. More All Out Show. We're going to talk to Chris. He tested out the sex pillow that they sent us. So we're gonna do a little talking. And that begins tomorrow. Don't miss any All Out Show.